We are taking this study beyond the shores of the United States, and we are very bullish that we have something of a unicorn in the making.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Dr. Raza Bokhari. He is the CEO of Medicus Pharma. And Dr. Bokhari, it's good to see you again. How are you?
Really doing well, Steve. So nice to be back on your program.
Yeah, good to talk to you. A couple of things to update everyone on. We'll talk about sort of the phase two clinical study in just a second. But we did talk recently in the past about an acquisition, and that acquisition is now closed. So thought it'd be a good opportunity to remind everyone a little bit about it and really what it means for the company.
Thank you so much, Steve. It is indeed an exciting time at Medicus Pharma. We have now closed the acquisition of Entev, which is a UK-based company focused on advancing clinical development program of next-generation gonadotropin-releasing hormone antagonist. We are no longer a one-trick pony. We're certainly very proud of our lead asset, SKNJCT, which is maturing nicely, but we now have under our umbrella more than one asset with three approved FDA-approved clinical studies to advance forward.
Yeah, and is that the idea to try and get into commercialization and revenue as quick as you're able to do that? Because with three, that's obviously a big positive for the company.
Well, the aim and the mandate of the company is to find these novel, potentially disruptive therapeutic assets and advance them through the proof of concept phase two studies and getting them one step closer to commercialization. While all options remain on the table for us, but our area of focus is to get them through this proof of concept, buy these assets for $10 million-$25 million, infuse 10 to 25 in their clinical development program, and with a positively trending data read, position them for acquisition for double-digit return on our invested capital. So in that sense, we are what we would call in the groove.
Okay. Let's talk about SKNJCT, because you mentioned that one, and you had news out recently that you've commenced the patient recruitment for the phase two clinical study. And this is in a number of different hospitals over in Abu Dhabi, correct?
Absolutely, Steve. So SKNJCT is a novel, non-invasive treatment alternative for the most common cancer of the skin, basal cell carcinoma of the skin, which has 5 million new cases just in the United States and globally, perhaps 25, 30 million plus new cases that emerge every year. So basal cell is not just an American problem. It's a global problem wherever there is sun and ultraviolet radiation and exposed skin surface, that is the breeding ground of this cancer. And from the days of Adam and Eve, the only effective treatment is surgical intervention. Our novel treatment, which is advancing very nicely in 9+ sites in the United States now, we are very excited that Cleveland Clinic Abu Dhabi in UAE has also started to commence patient recruitment and closely, very soon, American Hospital in Dubai and Sheikh Shakbout Medical Center and others, four additional sites would also commence patient recruitment. So we are taking this study beyond the shores of the United States, and we are very bullish that we have something of a unicorn in the making.
Yeah. Raza, are you happy with the way things are going? You obviously mentioned things are going well in the United States, but having a number of hospitals pick up things in the UAE as well, I would imagine exactly how you designed this to move forward.
This has been, while drug development is a a treacherous path. It is not as predicted. It is usually planning the unplannable. However, we are very fortunate that our SKNJCT phase 2 study for these doxorubicin tip-loaded microneedle arrays have been working out as planned and on schedule. I would even say that some of it has actually, we have been able to fast-track some of our work, which is a high commendation to our drug development team that has been working very hard, and we are very pleased with how things are progressing.
All right. Well, it's exciting times ahead still. Lots to talk about in the near future, and we'll have you back on to talk all about it. So thanks, Dr. Bokhari. Nice to see you again.
Thank you so much, Steve, for having me back on your program.
All right, Dr. Raza Bokhari, the CEO of Medicus Pharma.